Believe it or not, it's Monday. Today's February 23rd, 2009, and you're watching The Daily Left on Go Left TV. Thanks for joining me. The nearly eight-year-old mystery of the death of D.C. intern Chandra Levy may be close to being solved. According to officials, a Salvadoran immigrant convicted of attacking two women in the park where Levy's remains were found is expected to be arrested any time now in her slaying. The arrest will tie up the cold case of the 2001 killing that destroyed the career of former U.S. Representative Gary Condit of California. Apparently, back in 2002, investigators questioned the man about the slaying after he was convicted of attacking two female joggers in Washington's Rock Creek Park. He was not charged at the time, but statements he made to people in prison while serving 10 years for attacking those two women helped lead investigators back to him. According to law enforcement officials, the break came in part from DNA evidence that was either retested or collected and was connected to the currently incarcerated suspect. A grand jury has been convened in the matter and an arrest warrant is expected within days. Chandra Levy was 24 and had just completed an internship with the U.S. Bureau of Prisons when she disappeared in May 2001. Authorities questioned Condon in the disappearance, but he was never a suspect in her death. Condon was reportedly having an affair with Levy, and the negative publicity from the case was attributed for his overwhelming primary loss in 2002. Well, straight out of an action movie plot, a massive manhunt is underway in Greece after two criminals escaped from a high-security prison by helicopter for the second time in 3 years. Armed robber and kidnapper and his sidekick were days away from trial for their 2006 prison escape when they fled prison yesterday after a helicopter landed on the roof. After visiting the prison Sunday evening, the Justice Minister fired the Justice Ministry General Secretary, the Inspector General of Prisons, and the head of the prison where the escape took place. Police arrested three prison guards and a helicopter pilot today. Guards on the ground did open fire on the helicopter, but a woman on board shot back with an assault rifle. The helicopter was later found by a highway in a northern Athens suburb where the pilot was found bound and gagged with a hood over his head. He told police that the helicopter had been chartered by a couple who wanted a lift from central Greece to Athens, but later threatened him with a gun and forced him to fly to the prison.
You do that and you're gonna be in big trouble, mister. Jail even. Can you say prison bitch?
And finally, corporate America at its finest. Fast food giant McDonald's has denied workers' compensation benefits to Nigel Haskett, a minimum wage worker who was shot at work when he ejected a customer who had been beating a woman inside the restaurant. Seriously?
True story.
A rep of the administrator for Mickey D's workers' comp plan explained the decision, saying, "We have denied this claim in its entirety, as it is our opinion that Mr. Haskett's injuries did not arise out of or within the scope of his employment." Last summer, the 21-year-old Haskett saw a patron hit a woman in the face. A surveillance video of the incident shows Haskett tackle the man, throw him out, and stand by the door to prevent him from re-entering the building. The patron then went to his car, returned with a gun, shot Haskett multiple times, causing him to stagger back into the building and collapse. Haskett has since undergone three abdominal surgeries and has incurred over $300,000 in medical bills. The judge at the shooter's arraignment praised Haskett as a hero. It's decisions like this that have caused McDonald's to get and maintain its reputation as a greedy, evil corporate empire. Keep up the good work, McDonald's. You rock. That's all for the Daily Left for today. I'm Lee Morris. Thanks for watching Go Left TV. Citizens Media on the rise.